It's that time again. Mac power user or not, here are 7 tips you've probably never heard of. Number 1, emoji are a pretty big deal. However, I've seen way too many Mac users either Google the name of the emoji they want to use, copy and paste it into the document, which is simply bananas, or to use the character palette built into macOS. You pull up the window, you find the emoji you want, you click the color, and then it inserts. But neither of these honestly are very good methods. However, there is a handy shortcut. If you hit Control Command Space, this little character palette pops up that allows you to select any emoji you want. You can scroll through, click on the categories, or there's even a search bar, so I could type sad, and all the emojis that could possibly be affiliated with sadness pop up. I click it, and it inserts. Super easy. Number 2, we've all been there. You're typing a word and you are so hopelessly incorrect that not even the system spell check knows what you're trying to say. Well, as long as you know how the word begins, so onomatopoeia, I know that begins with O-N-O, I can press F5 on my keyboard and a list of every available word in the language I'm typing that begins with O-N-O shows up in this list. I can toggle down to the word I want, press space, and it inserts automatically. No spell check required. Number 3, believe it or not, Mac App Store only checks for system updates and application updates once per week, once every 7 days. That's a pretty long time. Maybe you want to check for updates more frequently, or maybe less frequently. I'm going to show you how. All you have to do is open Terminal, which you can find in Spotlight, or you can also find it in the Utilities folder under your Applications folder. Press Enter. Terminal opens and you're going to get this little window. Now all you have to do is copy and paste the code that I've left in the video description below, com.apple.SoftwareUpdate, and we're now going to set the schedule frequency in an integer, a number which is number of days. So the default is once every 7 days, once per week. You can change that integer to maybe once every 2 days, or once every 1 day, or once every 720 days. That's not recommended, obviously, but that's how often it will automatically check. If you want to do it once a day, minus INT, space 1, enter, and that's it. You're good to go. Number 4. I bet you already know about Quick Look. You know, where you select a file, press the space bar, and you can see a preview of that image, that video, Word document, PDF, whatever, without having to actually open it in the native application. What a lot of people don't know, however, is that if you select multiple files, you can also preview them together in Quick Look. So I've selected all these photos, I press the space bar, and then you'll see in this top menu bar, there's this little tiny icon. You can either click that or you can press Command Return, and all of your photos or documents or videos, what have you, will show up in this nice little grid. You can then view all of them, preview, you can scroll through to see all of them in detail. And then once you've selected the one you want to view again, you can press the return key and it shows up in its full resolution. Very, very handy. But wait, there's more. If you're like me, you probably leave your downloads folder in your dock. It's a really handy way to get a quick access to files that you've downloaded on the web. However, what a lot of people don't know is that Quick Look also works in here. All I have to do is hover over the file that I want to view, I press the space bar, and ta-da, I'm now getting a preview of that file. Number 5. If you've ever held down a key on your keyboard, for example, if I hold down N, a little menu pops up and I can put an enye or an accented N. Now this is handy if you type in multiple languages, but if you don't and you just want it to go N without having to actually press the button over and over and over again, there's a handy little terminal command. So again, open terminal. We've done it before. All you have to do is paste the command that I've included in the video description below. We press enter, and then you quit the application and you reopen it. So we'll reopen Tweetbot. And now when I hold down N, oh, I get all the N's to my heart's content. Now, if you want to change it back, you paste the same command, but change the Boolean from false to T-R-U-E, true. You press enter, you quit the application, you try to type down an N again, and it comes back to normal. Number 6. This one is a bit weird, but hear me out because it's pretty cool. Let's say you're copying and pasting a bunch of information from the web or from an email client or whatever, and you don't want to have to copy and paste and copy and paste the little fragments that you'd actually like to use. Well, here's a very handy trick. If you open System Preferences and go to Keyboard, and then you click Shortcuts, and then you go to the Services tab on the left and scroll down to where it says Text, you can then find this little tiny thing right here that says new text edit WI dot 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 containing selection. If I click the check mark and then program a shortcut, I'm going to make mine, I don't know, Control Option Command 1, Then what I can do is if I'm on the web and I copy a sentence or a line or whatever and I hit my shortcut, it will automatically copy and paste that into a brand new text edit document that I can keep track of separately. So all my little fragments that I copy and paste and copy and paste, they're all imported into documents automatically without me having to copy and paste them by hand. It's really pretty handy. Number 7, the last tip. This one is pretty awesome. Now, admittedly, most people don't steal MacBooks or iMacs anymore because of iCloud activation lock. If you lose your Mac, you can go to iCloud, say I lost my Mac, you can lock the device and it basically turns your laptop into a brick and it can never be unlocked, even by Apple. That's pretty cool, but let's say you just lose your laptop or you misplace it or there's lots of laptops in one office and you want to keep track of yours. Rather than putting a sticker or a label with your name and your telephone number on it, you can add that to the lock screen. It's really pretty handy. All you have to do to add it is open terminal once more, and then you will paste the following command. Now, where it says enter here, inside of the quotes, you enter your own custom message. Don't touch this. You press enter, and then once you've done that, it's totally good to go. You can quit terminal, and then you can log out of your computer, and holy smokes, it's there. It's really, really handy. And now, you're even more of a macOS pro. But check out my other videos for more Mac tips you probably haven't heard of. If you enjoyed this video, leave it a like. If you didn't like it, well, then that other button seems to work okay too. Get subscribed for more awesome tech videos like these. But most importantly, and as always, stay snazzy.